Hi, Professor Anzi. What is food security?
Okay, thanks for the question, Ivan. That's my professorship chair title is food security, so I'm used to explaining it to people. Because people do want to know what it means.
Asking for the right guy?
Yeah, so I mean, people are familiar with food safety, but not so much with food security. So it's something I explain at the beginning of most of my lectures. Food security is something that's been around for decades as a concept. It's evolved over time, but what it really means now is, can we provide sufficient food to everyone at all times? And is that food affordable? Is it accessible? Is it safe? Mm-hmm. And is it something that they want to eat? Is it utilizable, we call it? It means, does it meet my preferences? Does it meet the demands I have for a healthy lifestyle so I can contribute to society? So it covers sufficient food, it covers nutrition, and it covers price.
Okay, so from all of those, I would think that we would hope to have yes as an answer for most of those?
You need to have yes for all of them. If any one of those dimensions, if you like, is not met, then we have a problem with food security. If you don't produce enough, if you don't have access to it, like physically or economically, or if it's not the food that you wish to eat, for example, if somebody replaced your rice-based diet with maize, yeah, you'd survive, but you wouldn't be very happy, you know, because you miss that part of your culturally important diet. And you have to do that season after season, year after year. It has to be sustained. And if any of those isn't met, then you have a food security problem.
And can we mostly say yes in most countries? What's the situation?
It's an interesting question, and there's a map I could share with you that shows the variability in food security, like a food security index. And it's dynamic. It changes over time. What I can say is if you look at progress, let's say development in the world, we're doing much better now than we were 20, 30, 40 years ago. We've made huge steps in improving production to meet demand. We've made huge steps in access to food. If you think about what you can now get in a market, you know, the diversity of where food comes from around the world has improved. But in many parts of the world, it's still a struggle. Nutrition is a problem. Some people do not have enough to eat. And often a shock to the system, a drought or a flood, can have a serious impact on a lot of people because you suddenly have a loss of security that's difficult to fill the gap.
Okay. Are you trying to solve that?
Yes. Part of the work we do here addresses food security, and we look at those different dimensions. So using remote sensing technology, we try to assess food production. We try to look at the, let's say, the health of crops and their productivity to say, is it going to be a good year or a bad year? Do we detect a difference from previous years? We also look at things like access to food. So trying to map out what's the travel time for people to get to a market to buy food, or even what's the travel time for a farmer to get to a market to buy fertilizer or to buy seed. So you can see that the distance people have to travel is going to have an effect on the price. It's also going to have an effect on what's available to them, you know, in a near neighborhood, or do they have to travel a long way to get different things? So we also look at utilization as well. So we can also look at these different parts of the food security puzzle, if you like. Mm-hmm. And the nice thing about the data that we use, the remote sensing, is that it's year after year. So we can look at this as a kind of monitoring basis. So asking the question, are things better or worse? Do we see positive trends, or do we see something that should be a cause for concern?
Okay. What would you say is one of the major things affecting food security right now? Or does that have a kind of geographical...
It's a fascinating puzzle because it's so dynamic. Climate, of course, has an overarching impact on many things. That does have an impact on food security because the increased frequency and intensity of things like droughts and floods does affect the production side of things. It can also affect the accessibility side of things if roads get damaged or washed away in a landslide. So these are all things that we can look at. But I'd say overall, it's all of those different dimensions at one time or another become, you know, deserve critical attention to make sure that we're able to continue to sustainably meet our food security goals. But you'll see some countries produce a huge amount of food, or people in the country have access to sufficient food, that's fine. Others, it's more of a challenge to meet their food security goals.
And how do we help them?
We help with the kind of information we use, first of all, through monitoring, mm-hmm. On the production side. What can we say about the status of food production at a particular time of year? And doing it sufficiently early enough for policymakers, for example, to take decisions about import and exports. If they realize that there's going to be a shortfall, then they can look at other markets to bridge that gap. Or if they know it's going to be a particularly good year, they may start thinking about stockpiling and storage for the future. So that's one of the, I think, most obvious ways in which we can use remote sensing information to tell us something about production and allow people to take action sufficiently early to ensure food security.
I see. And the first thing you mentioned were a few you called dimensions, where ideally you would have yes for all the questions. Do you see a future where we have yes for everybody, for yes. every question?
Yes, I do. What I find fascinating about food production and food security in general is how much progress we've made over time. And yes, we still have challenges in different parts of the world. But through the technology of geoinformation and other, let's say other technologies, whether it's plant breeding or more information about markets and what people's demands and preferences are, you see all of these converging to try to answer the same question. And so we are making a lot of progress.
Do you want to be a GeoHero as well? Then take the first step and click the subscribe button and then the bell button to always be the first to know when one of our GeoHeroes posts a new video.